across from Paul McCartney, the French countryside's going by, and she plays the song he listened to with Elvis all those years ago. And he's drumming it out on the table and singing the song to me. And those are those moments where you just got to pinch yourself and go, I can't believe this is my life right now.
Welcome to WatchMojoUK, and today we're counting down our picks for the craziest Paul McCartney stories told by various celebrities.
Before we begin, we publish new content every day, so be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos.
Number 10, Patrick Stewart's story. Captain Jean-Luc Picard met all sorts of interesting characters on his adventures, but none made the man behind the character quite as nervous as one Sir Paul McCartney. Back when Patrick was acting in theatre productions, he once remarked to his co-star, who was Paul's girlfriend at the time, that he'd love an Aston Martin.
He's in the show tonight. He's come to see Jane. Jane Asher was his girlfriend.
To his surprise, a couple of weeks later, he heard a knock on his dressing room door. It was Paul McCartney. Unfortunately for Stewart, he was in just his undies.
Jane tells me that you like Aston Martins. Here, drive this.
That's when Paul threw him the keys to an Aston Martin and insisted they all go for a long drive. Stewart obliged, but couldn't quite enjoy himself, as all he could think about was that if he crashed the car, his name would be etched in history for the wrong reason.
It's the only thing I will be remembered for. This is the man who killed Paul McCartney.
Number 9. Steve Holly's story. In the days after the Beatles, Paul lived a quieter life in the countryside for a period of time. It was there that he met Steve Holly, who would eventually become the drummer for his band Wings. During a Beatles Fest panel, Steve allegedly told a story of a night out drinking he had with Paul. The two were walking down the streets in the middle of the night, absolutely sloshed. All of a sudden, Paul turns to Steve and asks, "Do you hear a horse coming?" When Steve said yes, Paul exclaimed, "Oh no, that's my wife." Apparently, Linda would come find Paul on horseback when he would go out drinking, and after giving him a stern talking to, she'd make him hop on the back of the horse and carry him home. Number 8. Bill Bailey's story. We've all found ourselves being starstruck when meeting a celebrity. Even other celebrities experience the same, apparently. Comedian Bill Bailey of Black Books fame recalled the time he met Paul while on stage. In his head, he had this elaborate speech to make about how profoundly impacted he was by hearing a Beatle live.
And I thought, if ever I get to meet Paul McCartney, I want to try and tell him. I want to try and say this, try and describe this experience. Because I bet no one's ever told him how brilliant he is.
Only it came out completely wrong, apparently.
Because I was so nervous. I went, "Your songs, like, with a tapestry and everything, like a thread."
The story gets harder and harder to listen to as Bill keeps struggling to get his words out.
I try and tell this story to Paul McCartney. Doesn't come out quite right. This is how it comes out. Paul. Actually, Tony Bennett, he went...
When saying their goodbyes, Bill left Paul with a gift he wouldn't soon forget.
He goes, just as an afterthought, he looked at me and went, "I'll be watching you on the TV." And I turned to him and I went, "And I'll be watching you." And I poked him in the eye.
Number 7, Rob Lowe's story.
And I walked in and Paul McCartney was there.
Mm.
And I was like, I could barely eat.
Film and TV star Rob Lowe is another one who's been lucky enough to sit down and have a meal with Paul. As he recalls it, as they were eating, one of Paul's songs came on. He caught Paul singing along.
And he's literally sitting there and he's like, "So if you want some fun, take old blah dee blah da." And he looks up at me and he sees that I've seen him. And then he turns red and gets embarrassed. Then I get embarrassed that I've seen him do it.
What makes this story so hilarious, though, is Lowe's horrendous impression of McCartney.
And then he doesn't really know what to say, and he looks at me and says, "Oh, it's not even really a lyric. It just sort of popped into my head at the time. I mean, what does it mean?"
Sorry, where is he from at this point?
I know.
I knew it.
It's enough to distract you from what the story is even about. It ends with Paul being told off by his daughter for pretending to not know what his lyrics meant.
"If you want some fun, take oh blah dee blah da." What does it mean? I don't know what it means. And his daughter, I'll never forget, said, "Dad, you're an idiot. You know what it means. It meant take drugs."
Number 6, Nat Wolff's story.
Entire life, I used to write Paul McCartney letters. All and give it to, I'd hear you'd be at a restaurant, I'd write him a letter, I'd give it to the host.
While Nat Wolff's portrayal of Light in the horrendous Death Note adaptation left many fans in tears, it was Nat himself who was blubbering after this experience.
Ah! Ah! Oh! Oh! Oh!
Nat's been a McCartney fan his whole life, even dressing up as him on Halloween when he was younger. So when the opportunity arrived to meet him, as the two were in the same restaurant, Nat seized the day. Well, he tried to, at least.
My friend said, I think you need to sit down. As I'm sitting down, I thought like something terrible had happened. And he said, Paul McCartney's here. And like a girl, 14-year-old girl in the 60s, I just started bawling.
Much like Bailey, when meeting him, he was utterly starstruck. He just fell to pieces. But luckily, Paul, being Paul, had some kind words to say.
And then he says, he's like, I've got a good feeling about you. Keep going with what you're doing. And I burst into tears. I just start sobbing.
Number 5, Billy Joel's story. American musician Billy Joel once arranged with Paul and his agents to come over to his house and jam. He opened up his fridge to see what he could offer Paul while he was over, and his fridge was full to the brim with different meats.
And I'm looking at my fridge and I'm seeing, you know, like turkey breast and, cold beef or something. And it's starting to look like Jeffrey Dahmer's refrigerator.
Right.
I'm thinking if Paul opens the fridge, he's going to freak out and he's going to run out of my house.
However, if you know Paul, you know he's a prolific vegetarian. With this in mind, Joel tried to make his home as accommodating as possible and decided to hide away all the meat so that Paul wouldn't feel uncomfortable or judge him.
So I decide I'm going to take all the meat out of the refrigerator and put it somewhere else.
Right.
Literally, I was going to hide the salami. So I go through the fridge and I'm pulling out this, pulling out that, and I'm hiding it in drawers.
Fortunately, Paul never opened any of the drawers because that would have been a lot more bizarre than finding meat in the fridge. Unfortunately, Joel ended up forgetting he had stored the food away.
And I'm like thrilled and I'm calling everybody up. Yeah, Paul was at the house. We were hanging out, man. We're talking music. And then like a few days go by and I'm walking around my house like, what's that smell?
Number 4, Dave Grohl's story. Musician Dave Grohl actually has quite a few stories about hanging out with Paul. After all, the two are friends. They've played together on stage and Paul even inducted the Foo Fighters into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. So it's little wonder Grohl gets a little choked up whenever he tells this story of when Paul came over to his house.
We had just had Ophelia, our youngest, and Paul and Nancy were in town. They said, like, okay, we want to come see the new baby. She was a week old.
Apparently, on his way, Paul spotted the family's piano and couldn't help but give it a spin. That's when Grohl's daughter sat next to him and Paul began teaching her how to play.
She sat down and she watched his hands. They sat together and he was showing her what to play.
Even making a song together.
It was the only time I've ever taken a picture of Paul. Because to me, I don't really want to do that. I just want to kind of be his friend.
The story does have a hilarious twist ending for when he saw his daughter the next day, but it's still a lovely one.
And I came around the corner and she looked at me as she was playing the piano. She realized I was watching and she never played the piano again.
Oh, for God's sake.
Number 3, Ringo Starr's story. The Beatles documentary Get Back was eye-opening for fans as they were treated to some never-before-seen footage of their heroes. One thing we certainly didn't expect to see was Ringo suddenly owning up to being the one who let off a fart.
If anybody let a silent one go, they would try and get away with it.
According to Starr, silent farting was a pretty common nuisance among the band. It became such a problem that they'd have to agree to announce who it was that released the stench each time so that it didn't become a witch hunt.
So anyway, we realized, okay, it was me. You know, or it was him. It didn't matter, but you just said it and everything calmed down.
When asked who the gassiest Beatle was, Ringo said, you guessed it.
Paul.
Paul.
Number 2. The Gallagher Brothers stories. These brothers, known for their work as Oasis, have been very vocal about their love for the Beatles over the years. Lucky for them, they've both met this legend. In Noel's case, he told the story of meeting Paul at one of his homes.
And I kind of had longish hair, and he said, hey, you look like a Beatle. And I said, so do you.
Paul was a very courteous host, showing off his unique house. But there's one part of their meetup that came across as a bit too intimate for Noel.
And he pressed this button and the bed goes up into a tinier bubble. And he said, yeah, we used to kind of sit out here, you know, in the 60s and look at the stars. And it was just me and him. And I was thinking, you better not try and go off of me.
Liam's stories are, well, a little bit different. He's met with Paul many times and also says he's lovely. But when this interview was posted in NME, he recalled the latest interaction where McCartney offered him a margarita. Liam declined, saying he wasn't hungry, only for McCartney to give him a lashing, saying he's talking about the cocktail, not a pizza. Number 1. Koji Kondo's story. In the conversation of greatest video game music composer of all time, Koji Kondo is certain to get a mention. He's responsible for some of the most iconic Nintendo tunes ever conceived, but there's one story that made even him stunned. During Paul's tour of Japan in the 80s, Koji Kondo and famed game designer Shigeru Miyamoto were invited backstage. To his shock, when McCartney approached him, he started singing the tune to Super Mario. Bear in mind, video games were much more niche at this time, so Kondo certainly wasn't expecting Paul to be a fan. Paul would go on to tell the two that while he himself was not very good at games, he would often hear the tunes as his children and grandchildren would play. Have you ever met any celebrities and walked away with hilarious stories? Let us know in those comments below.
Do you agree with our picks? Check out this other recent clip from WatchMojoUK and be sure to subscribe and ring the bell to be notified about our latest videos.